and murdered his brother. I want you to see that it was because he belonged to the evil one that he murdered his brother. First of all, we have to belong to the enemy. We have to refuse Christ.
Right, right.
And we see it's by default.
Right.
Unless you choose Christ, you default to the devil. Because you're made to, you're a spirit being, and you're a creature, and you have to have something to lead you. You have to have God to help. Come on, y'all. Some idol, something. Anything but the true one living God is going to pour evil into your life. You'll be connected to the devil. Anything that you put in front of you to worship, to follow, to believe, will destroy you other than God. Come on, y'all. So do not be like Cain, who belonged to the evil one. And he murdered his brother. And why did he murder him? Because his own actions were evil and his brother's were righteous. Do not be surprised, my brothers, if the world hates you. We know that we have passed from death to life because we love our brothers. And anyone who does not love remains in death. Anyone who hates his brother is a murderer. And you know that no murderer has eternal life. Thank God for John, who in confronting all that was going on in the churches in that day, that the enemy was getting in through false teachers and telling the people that you can sin and be a Christian. And that is a lie that has been going ever since.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen.
There's one hope for us only, and that is Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Life in Jesus Christ. We have life that never ends in Jesus Christ. If you are in Christ and something happens to you, it really doesn't matter. Something terrible can happen to you. You can be in a wreck, you can be shot, you can be, something can happen. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter what happens. If you are in Christ, you will go to be with him. Praise God.
Amen.
Praise God. Praise God. Well, I have a sister. How many of you remember my sister Linda? Yeah, she's been here several times. And maybe a year or two ago, she opened up to me about her life. Sitting in my house, she began to share with me kind of how it all started, that her life went so far in the wrong direction. She said that she was a teenager, and she said that Dad, you know, the rules that Dad had in our home, she didn't want to obey them. And so she was about the age of accountability. And she said, when I told Dad that I didn't want to do what he told me to do, she said, I realized I was rebelling against God. And she said, if I had only known then what she knew 30, 40 years later, she said she would have never rebelled against our Father. Because her life went down, down, down. She was telling me that every decision she made out there put her life in a worse mess. That she was under that power of the enemy. So in her 20s, in her 30s, in her 40s, in her 50s, she went through one man after another, married, divorced, another man, a marriage, a divorce, another man. She couldn't control her life. She was out of control. One man right after another. She became a lawyer, but her spending was out of control, and she went bankrupt. Couldn't control her spending. She couldn't control. She wanted pleasure. She wanted to be involved in all these different kinds of dancing and different clubs and different this and different that, to where when I talked to her, when she was wanting a change in her life, she said, I don't know how I got to where I am. So I began to talk to her. I said, you don't have to stay. You don't have to go through this cycle. You don't have to keep going this way. And it wasn't very long until she would actually lost her job as assistant city attorney of Tulsa. And she ended up in a employment agency, or a whatever it is where they pay you when you're not working. What is it called? Unemployment.
Unemployment.
And she walks in there, and there's two guys from a church. And they invite her to church. Wow. And she said, right then, I gave my life to Christ.
Yeah.
6 or 7 years old. Because we just started seeing her life change.
Amen.
And said, Linda, please tell us what's happened. You don't talk, you're not into all this false religion. You're not, I mean, she was a radical abortion rights advocate. She ran for state senate of Oklahoma on the platform of more rights for women to kill babies, you know. I mean, everything about her life just was death. Death, death. And we said, Linda, what happened? What happened? She said, all I know, I was ready.
Amen.
I was sick. I was sick of my life.
Amen.
I was sick of what the devil had done in my life. This was a couple of years ago, and she said, every decision I made my life worse.
Yes.
But every decision since Christ came into my life.
Amen.
And he's been my power. He's been my
life. Yes.
Everything has worked out good.
Amen.
She had 10 relationships out there in sin, or more, or 15, and she's been married to the same guy for the last 15 years.
Amen.
He's a bag of bones. And sorry, but he's just a bag of bones. He's just so sick. She loves him to the death.
Amen.
She said, my purpose in life is to keep my husband alive and to help him in every way that I can.
Yes,
to help him. That's my sister.
Amen.
Amen. Aren't you thankful that he made a way back?
Yes, amen.
He made a way. Guys, she spent on herself so much, she went bankrupt. But since she's come to Christ, she gives to the kingdom way more than she spends.
Amen. That's right. That's
She's
right.
given to our church almost every month since I've been here. She gives $500 a month to our church. Come on, y'all. Amen. They give and they give and they give and they give.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen. Guys, there's nothing that flows from our life that's really good unless it's Christ. Nothing good that can flow. There's nothing good that can come from our life. There's no good that we can do in this world unless Christ is in us.
Amen.
Praise God. There's no good that we can do. In fact, what we're doing is we're hurting. Come on, y'all.
Right.
Every time we sin, we're hurting everybody around us. Every time we sin, every time we do something that's shady, every time we say something that's off, come on, y'all. Every time we don't warn people for their sin, we're hurting. We're hurting. We're hurting. We're hurting. When do we want it to be different? When do we want it to be different? How long are you going to wait? How long are you going to wait for it to be different? How much more damage are you going to do? How much more damage are you going to do? How many are willing to hear that today? Raise your hand. If you're not in Christ, you're doing damage. Pray the Holy Spirit will prick your heart. I want to stop doing damage. I want to stop hurting myself and everybody around me. I want it.
Amen. Amen. Praise God.
us to stand and I want us to pray. I want us to pray. We have a choice, oh Lord. We have a choice. We can be like Abel. We can go with God. Oh, we can escape the traps the devil has on for us. Oh Lord, there's so many dangers out there ahead of us without Christ. Lord, there's so much evil. There's so many ways the devil's going to pull us in deeper. If we are not absolutely all in for Christ. Lord, lip service is not enough. Going to that church sometimes is not enough. Looking at the Bible on our table is not enough. There's no ritual we can go through that's enough. The only thing that's enough is to come clean.
Amen.
Only thing that is enough is to come clean. And say, I'm sorry, God. I'm sorry I've sinned against you. The prodigal said, I've sinned against God and I've sinned against heaven. And I've sinned against my Father. He came with repentance. And oh my goodness, his Father welcomed him with open arms. In fact, his Father ran to meet him. What a God. What a God. Christ came to destroy the works of the devil. The only works that are hurting this world is what people do. God, we don't want to be one of those. We don't want to be one of those. We want to stop hurting our spouse. We want to stop hurting our kids. We want to stop hurting our parents. We want to stop hurting our neighbors. Oh, Lord Jesus, I pray you just move right now in every heart. And I pray, Lord, that everyone who has sin in their life will have the courage. Lord, you have the courage to die for us. I pray that everyone that has sin or any compromise in our life would have the courage to say, Pastor Barbara, I want prayer. Pastor Barbara, I want prayer. And would you just raise your hand? Just raise your hand. Today, please don't look around. Please. Anyone that says, I want a new life, raise your hand. I don't want to compromise anymore. I don't want to keep doing the same.
Great.
Thank you, oh God. Is there anyone? Is there anyone? I want Christ. I want Christ. I want Him in my life. I want to be the right kind of husband. I want to be the right kind of wife. I don't want this stuff. I want to open the altar. I don't want this in my life. I don't want stuff in my life. I want the devil in my life. I don't want the devil to have any power in me. I don't want the enemy to gain the victory over me. I don't want him to master me. I don't want him to rule my life. I want to have God's power over the enemy. Thank you, God. The Bible says greater is the one that is in us than the one that is in the world. And, oh, there's power for us in Christ, oh Lord. There's power for us in Christ. There's life in Christ. Oh, we have a future. The Bible says that we have a future and a hope. We have purpose. We have purpose, Lord. We have a future. We have future with you, oh Lord. Jesus, we need your help. We need your life every day. We need to call on you every day. We need to trust in you every day. Lord Jesus, we need to lean strong on you, hard on you. We need to draw our life from you every day. Lord Jesus, thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, I pray. I pray. pray, Lord, that there's a big change. Praise you, Jesus. Anyone that's battling in sin, we just pray. Oh, Lord, they'll just yield to you. Yield their life to you and say, I don't want it my way. I want it your way, God. I want your life. I want your power. I want your holiness in me. I want to live for you. You died for me. I want to live for you. Oh, Lord Jesus, take the alcohol. Take whatever it is. Take the things I'm watching on television. Take the way I talk. Take that out of me and give me life. Take away the sin and give me life. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.